In this apothecary DIY, I'm going to show you how to make a bottle or a vial of adolescent phoenix tail feathers. That means that these feathers were supposedly obtained through natural means that do not harm little baby phoenixes. Yes, they were molted. The best part of these is that they have actual gold on the feathers. I'm going to show you how to turn the feathers gold, how to place them in the bottle so that they look aesthetically pleasing, and I'm going to show you how to make and attach the label. In order to make the actual feathers for this project, you're going to need some 1 to 2 inch feathers. I like the frayed kind because it makes it look more like baby feathers. Some packing tape and some gold spray paint. You'll also need some newspapers to lay down underneath your workspace so you don't spray paint everything gold. The first thing you're going to want to do is to cut off about 5 inches of packing tape. This is going to hold your feathers in place so while you spray paint, they don't fly all over the place. You can also layer the feathers in a way that keeps the whole feather from being covered and you get to target just the area that you want. I start with the biggest feathers first as a foundation, and then I build on it with the smaller ones. Don't push too hard because you do want these to come off easily without ripping at the feather. When I put the second feather and all the rest of them on, I'm going to overlap a little bit. I'm not going to cover the whole thing. I'm going to leave the ends exposed so that they can get more paint, and the bottom covered more so it gets less paint. Now, if you want your whole feather to be golden, then you can just tape these down without any overlap at all. I like the look of having just the ends colored. If you want to do more feathers, you can either do a longer piece of tape or you can do a second piece of tape. It's really up to you. Once you are done laying down your feathers, you're ready to spray paint. Depending on how much gold you want showing on your feathers, you might want to get further away to create less gold and closer up to create more gold on each feather. I like mine to have just a light touch of gold, so I'll do mine far away. Then I'm going to leave these here to dry. I'll flip them and I'll do it again. Now that these are dry, I can flip them. The tape is still pretty sticky, so I'll just reuse the tape that I already have. Be gentle with these, especially if you have the frayed feathers. You don't want to rip any of the little spindly pieces off. You can see how having a feather on top of the bottom half of each feather has created a blank spot with no gold. We're ready to spray again. Giving myself a little distance, I spray again. Leave these to dry and then bring them back inside when they don't smell anymore. These are the materials you're going to want to use while you make the tag part of the project. You're going to need a tag, some sort of string or twine. And if you'd like to make the label using calligraphy, you're going to need some kind of calligraphy pen and ink. You'll also need a tiny bit of hot glue and some regular glue. First, I'm going to pour a small portion of my ink into my little miniature ink pot. It's very unofficial. It's really just the plug, but it is perfect. We're filling with just the right amount of ink, and then I'm going to set the rest of my ink far away. Before you begin, I would recommend you get a piece of cardstock or paper and practice using a calligraphy pen on that until you get the feel for writing with a calligraphy pen. If you're using a regular pen, that obviously doesn't matter. I do have a piece of paper towel here because after dipping into the ink, my nib often has too much ink and it will bleed. So I then dip it onto the paper towel to absorb some of the extra ink. After your tag has dried, then you can add the string or twine to it. In order to make the tag hang off from the bottle, I find it most effective to fold at the center and twist. This, however, does not keep the twist in place very well, depending on what you use, so you can go ahead and reinforce it with a bit of clear glue. I found that all you really need is about half a drop for the whole thing, and then twist it back up nice and tightly and smooth the glue over. I usually just stick the glue bottle on top of the string to keep it from unraveling while it dries. After the feathers have dried, I go through and pick a variety of shapes and sizes that I might use in this bottle. I then also go through and I find the prettiest side of each feather so that I know which side I'll be presenting on the outside of the glass. Then you're ready to make your choices. So I like to start with bigger ones and sort of fill the outside layer of the bottle. This kind of requires a little bit of bend in the feather. So if you see the feather is resisting the shape of the bottle, you can go ahead and just bend the stem of it a bit so that it curves with the glass. You don't want it to be too much because then it'll be visibly kinked. You want it just enough to go with the flow of the bottle. I also like to make sure there's something in the bottom so that when you're looking up into it, it doesn't look like an empty bottle. After about 3 big to medium feathers and something on the bottom, you still feel like it's a little empty feeling. Then you could go ahead and find maybe one more to stand up in it. Try to find a way where it doesn't clash with the other feathers. And maybe even provides a little bit of stability for that bottom feather so that when you dip it upside down, the little feather doesn't fly around. Then I take just the tiniest amount of glue at the bottom of the cork, about a half an inch of a thin line on one side and half an inch of a thin line on the other side. And then put the cork in. That's just enough to keep the cork in place because my corks are not very tight. Once your tag is finished drying, you'll be able to glue that on as well. This also only requires the teensiest bit of glue. You don't want to create lumps. Try to plan ahead when you do this part. Think, which side am I going to want to present on my shelf as the front? Then position the label where you think you'll want it to go. Take one side, put just a little bit of glue on the bottle under the end of the twine or string if you're using string. Hold it in place while it dries. Make sure this is fairly tight, but not so tight that it pulls off the other end of your string. If you like this episode of my Apothecary DIY, then go ahead and like this video and subscribe. And leave a comment and let me know if you're planning on making this yourself at home. Until next time, keep geeking out. Bye.